matter what background you come from, as long as you've got a certain skill set with you, then you can become an astronaut, and you can bring a lot to the table with the various experiences that you pick up during your life.
Cool, thank you very much.
Hi Tim, kind of following on from that question, I'm lucky enough to do a bit of flying with the Air Force, and I was just wondering how different it is to flying and being up there, because obviously you've got all the G-forces and stuff, but if there's anything that's very different from that?
Yeah, that's a great question. It's very interesting because, you know, we're travelling a lot faster, but things happen a lot slower. Because, you know, generally speaking, up here, you've got time to talk about your decisions, you'll often consult with the ground, you might make a phone call to the flight director to discuss something. And even in emergency situations, there are only one or two things that are time critical, and then the rest of the emergency actually occurs in relatively slow time as well. So it's very different to aviation, where, you know, in aviation often you're completely responsible for your own actions, and you have to implement those actions in a lot more timely manner. So I think that's a big difference. Is up here, it's a huge team effort when anything goes wrong.
Okay, and I'm going to be really cheeky and ask one more question. I'm following you on Facebook, I'm loving your videos, I was wondering, are you going to be putting up any videos that are more specifically physiological, because so far they've been more general population, so especially love the one about going to the toilet, but I was just wondering if you were going to post up any more scientific ones.
Yes, absolutely. In fact, there's a whole host of educational videos that is on my task list. The task list is kind of my Saturday afternoon job list that I have to get done. Obviously, in the first month up here, we've been focusing on two spacewalks and unpacking the Cygnus cargo vehicle that's attached to the space station at the moment. And in the next 4 to 5 weeks, things are going to quieten down a little bit for us on the space station, so I'm going to be ticking off a lot of those educational programs and getting some more of those videos done.
Brilliant, thank you.
One last question then.
You're welcome.